Hello everyone, the Hindu analysis for 22-9-2018. The first news item, India calls off New York meeting with Pakistan. So this is, India has actually blamed a Pakistan-based entity for killing the three police officers in Kashmir, and this is one of the reasons to why they have called off the meeting of the foreign ministers in New York. So this was repeatedly there in the news that India and Pakistan are getting together to have a meeting in New York. So the same meeting has been taken out, and MEA, that's the Minister of External Affairs, have also made it clear that this was one of the stamps which were being issued by the Pakistan in general. This was with respect to the memory of the Kashmir militant Burhan Wani, as this was one of the reasons for also the cancellations of the meeting to what they had to have in New York. And this was also one of the statements intimating both the situations with respect to killing the police officers and also the memory of the Kashmirs. Mr. Wani, that is with respect to the stamps issue, has actually made the Pakistan to glorify the terrorists and also the terrorism, which has been confirmed. So this is one of the main reasons to why the cancellation has been happened. So this is one of the important aspects. Nothing much to get out of it. That's the first thing. Secondly, India mooted the role for Anil Ambani's firm in Rafael deal. So this is with respect to the deal where we have like an importing of 36 Rafael jets from in the concerned country, that is France. So here there was a statement with respect to the former French president, that is Francois Hollande. He claimed that the Indian government has suggested that the industrialist Anil Ambani company as the offset partner. So this is for the deal of nearly 7.87 euro billions for the purchase of 36 Rafale fighter jets. So here he made it very clear that the government didn't have a choice. In sense, the France government didn't had a choice to select the Reliance Defense, but it was the company, in sense the government from India, which has suggested the name. But much earlierly, what the government has stated that 1 year prior to it, this particular discharge where the DA, that's a dissolved, right, was completely free to select the Indian offset partner to provide the deals at the time of seeking the offset credits. So we have nothing to do, and this has nothing where the government of India has been suggesting on Anil Ambani. But in the recent meeting, the France president had made it clear that they had no choice, rather it was the government who suggested the industrialist Anil Ambani company to be as an offset partner. So this is one of the important sidelines to what's happening on the Rafale jets deal. And the opposition party member Mr. Gandhi is also trying to oppose him to the deals and get a clarity on what's happening with respect to the Rafale deal. So it's one aspect. The next one, ISRO setting up a launch pad for Gaganyaan mission. So we know that the 75th Independence Day, before that we have to have a three-man Indian crew into the low orbit. That's with respect to 7 days, which is a very ambitious roadmap, which has been announced by the Prime Minister of India on the Independence Day. So here the development work is being done by ISRO. So on account of it, this ISRO is setting up a third launch pad at Sriharikota. So it is to undertake the Gaganyaan manned space flight program. So this is one of the important aspects. In addition, so ISRO is also looking out to set up another launch pad for SSLV, that is the small satellite launch vehicles, which is to be set up in Gujarat. So this is one of the two important aspects to what the ISRO has been looking out for. And you should also know that the deadline is by 2022, that is before 75th Independence Day they wanted, and 40 months more which has been left out. And this idea which mooted was on the year 2004, and by then the critical technologies to make it more validated, they have done the various tests, and few to be named as Space Capsule Recovery Experiment, Crew Model Atmospheric Reentry Experiment, and the Pad Abort Test. So these were the tests with respect to the manned mission. And apart from that, ISRO will use the GSLV Mk-3 launch vehicle. So this is the one which carries a heavier payload of the Gaganyaan. This is from the new launch pad to what they're planning to be as a third launch pad. And this third launch pad, apart from that, as we discussed, it is also looking for a new location near the Gujarat for the SSLV. So this is one of the important aspects. And the SSLV main traits is that it is actually expected to reduce the launch time and also the cost. So to make the launch small satellites, and this is one of the most important demands to what we have in the field. So this is one of the important aspects, and the basic details you have it out here. The spacecraft will be placed in the low earth orbit of 300 to 400 kilometers, and basic like GSLV launch vehicle, and how many days they're going to stay what is the astronauts and how are they being taken and what is the budget period, you have the complete details here. And the next one, ban on adoption of live-in partners lifted. So earlierly in the said May 31st, the CARA, that is the Central Adoption Resource Authority, had barred the applicants in a live-in relationship from adopting a child on the ground that they would not be able to adopt it unless and until they have a stable family. Any individual who is in a live-in relationship, they would not be considered as a stable family and henceforth they would not be able to adopt a child. So this was one of the important aspects. But the latest decision which has been coming from the steering committee of the CARA, they said that this particular aspects, in sense the lift of this particular rule or a circular which has been issued by the CARA, has been lifted out and it will be benefiting both the domestic as well as the international applicants. So what is right now is that here the individuals in a live-in relation can be able to adopt a child from or within the India after the country's nodal adoption agency, where it has decided them to give the permission to go ahead and make their adoptions. So this is one of the important aspects. And you should also know about the criteria with respect to the adoption regulations 2017. Here, a single woman is being permitted to adopt a child of any gender, irrespective of whether it's a male or a female. But a man, single man, would not be able to adopt the girl. He should adopt only a boy child. So again, when a married couple seeks to adopt a child, it needs to give its consent for the adoption, and also they should be a stable marriage for at least 2 years. So if they're fulfilling these criteria, they can go ahead and make their adoptions. And there's also applicants, they have to prove to be physically, mentally and financially stable to raise a child. So they just adopt a child and they're being completely ill tempt or with respect to having a financial background which has been completely ill, or physically if they're not strength, then there's no point in raising a child in return. So these are the basic criteria as to what the CARA looks on for, the Central Adoption Resource Authority. The next one, agency to do eco impact checks. So you have the Environment Ministry, which is actually proposing to allow the research organizations and also aggregated agency to monitor if the companies are actually complying with the environmental conditions. So this is one of the important proposals which has been coming from the Environment Ministry. And apart from that, there are certain central government, in sense they are proposing to introduce the concept called randomizing the third party compliance, where they would be able to do a proper clearance conditions through the national level reputed and a competent government institutions, which would be empaneled with the ministry. So the ministries with the institutions with the government and a national level reputed ones are the ones who should be doing up with the third party compliance to ensure that the environment clearance would be done. And apart from that, here the project developers, they have to submit themselves the environment impact assessment. So they have to come up with a proper kind of an independent agencies which they have come up with the project developers, and they have to ensure that that proposed project is something where it gives a complete report on the impact assessment as well. So apart from that, they have to ensure that these particular projects and also the activities has been assessed and they are studied, and the mitigation measures which are being implemented to avoid and also minimize the adverse environmental impact to what we have right now. So based on the size of the project, they will be either cleared or they might be rejected. So that's one of the important aspects. And the process also obligates that this particular compliance would be on 6 monthly compliance report, and this would be suggesting whether the industries are complying with the norms or not. So this regional offices would be checking out on the same aspects. But few of the observers has described this proposal to be as a big shift, because this is on how the projects have been appraised on. So this is one of the core issue which might be affecting the people keeping out of the monitoring and also compliance of the paperwork which has been embedded with this particular proposals. So this is kind of an observer to what they're trying to understand from this new outcome from the Union Environment Minister. So that's about it. And the next one, China wants US of consequence over sanctions. So here we, the China, which has actually won the US to withdraw the sanctions to what it has been imposed on the Chinese military organization for buying the Russian weapons, or they have to bear the consequences to what the Beijing, that is China, gives in response to USA. So this with respect to the sanctions or to the deal what is being between China and Russia. So that is a buying of weapons. And you know, one of the Chinese foreign minister, he also expressed that Beijing has been a strong indignation, and this is actually violating the basic norms of the international relations, and it is also damaging the US and China's relations. So this is one of a very important aspect which has to be looked on and US Department earlier it also announced that this was placing a sanctions on the China's equipment development department. So this is with respect to where there is a significant transactions with Russia with respect to nodal arms reporter, that is Rosoboron export. So this is one of the main aspects why the sanctions has been imposed. And here the sanctions had been linked with the China's import of 10 Su-35 jets and also with respect to S-4 surface-to-air missile system to the year 2018. So on limelight of this is what the US has been sanctioning, and this is one of the strong indications. And apart from that, the sanctions bar the Chinese company from applying with respect to any kind of an export licenses, and they would also not be getting any of the US financial systems, and they're also barred from getting the US visas as well. So this sanction is also covering other three aspects which has been there. And again, they also made it that the one of the Chinese media was also trying to make it clear that the US has also made an order where the state-run news agency and the English language state broadcaster, that is China Global Television Network, they have to register themselves to the foreign agents under the Foreign Agents Registration Act. So this is one of the local media in China which is making a report to what the US has been ordered on. So this is one of the important aspects. Meanwhile, Russia also has been talking about the new sanctions to what the US has been imposed on China. And Mr. Peskov, he also accused that the Washington was playing unfairly. And this is actually trying to squeeze the Moscow, which has been in the global market. So they wanted to take out the Moscow from the global arms market. This is one of the important aspect to what the Russia has been talking about, unfairly kind of a play to what the US is playing in return. So this is about it. And the next one, SEBI revises KYC's norms for the foreign portfolio investors. So this is with respect to the SEBI, which has announced a revised guidelines for Know Your Client, which is for the requirement of the foreign portfolio investors, which is allowing the NRIs, the RIs as resident of Indians, then the OCIs, the overseas citizens of Indians, to be part of the FPIs investing in India. So here, to whatever we have listed right now, they would be having an aggregate holding such as an OC fund, which would be less than 50% of the corpus of the fund. But an individual share of such entities, they would not be exceeding more than 25% in any of the foreign portfolio investments. So again, they're making like any of the contributions from an NRI, OCR, RI, which is including the controlled investment manager, then they have to be below 25% from a single, where they can be below 50% to the corpus of FPI. So they also made it very clear that the regulator had laid down that the FPIs can be controlled by the investment managers, so which are being owned and controlled by the NRIs, OCIs and the RIs. So this is one of the important regulations to what has been coming with respect to their home jurisdiction, and also they have to be registered with the SEBI. So this is one of the important guidelines to what the regulator had been put forth. So here the existing FPIs will be given 2 years term, because there is a new regulations which is coming to the force, and they have to fulfill with all the new eligibility criteria. For any temporary breach of the norms, then the entry will be like 90 days to comply with the regulations. But apart from that, they would be subject to the periodic review as well in many material information or disclosure, which would be having a warrant for such a review. But the categories of the FPIs, which is under 2 and 3, which is from a high risk jurisdiction, then the KYC review would be done annually. So this is one of the important aspects, making a periodic review, and category 2 and 3 under the annual review is what the SEBI is trying to make it very clear under the new proposals to what the SEBI has been giving on. So there's again very important developments on the FPIs. And the next one, floor CPA over, I'm sorry, cover for motor insurance hiked to 15 lakhs. So we have the minimum compulsory personal accident. So this is the cover for the owner drivers, which is under the motor insurance policy, has been increased to rupees 15 lakh. So with this increasement, we have a mandatory of an immediate effect where there is an higher annual premium, which has to be paid as rupees 750, and also follows a directive from the insurance regulator, that is IRDA. So this also you should know about the organization IRDAI. And at present, the cover for the two-wheelers, which is rupees 1 lakh, for which the annual payment is just around like 50. While for the private cars and the commercial vehicles, the minimum is 2 lakh and the premium would be around 100. So this is one of the important aspects on the compulsory personal accident coverage. The next one, US-China trade spat on can impact China. So we have the trade frictions between US and China, and this has been a very worrisome, and this is one of the important aspects to what Mr. Birla has been quoting on, and this is one of the important with respect to the Hindalco subsidiaries. So this was one of the situations to what he's trying to forecast it with respect to the US and China's trade frictions. And he also expressed that the import of the aluminium of and also the copper have been continued to hurt the domestic aluminium and also the copper industries. So this is also one of the threat which has been coming from the Chinese material which is coming to India. And there was one of the reporter who asked about the kind of an closure of the Vedanta copper unit in Tamil Nadu. So I've been benefited out of it. And the reply to what Mr. Birla gave was that the competitor's plant has been closed, but the Chinese imports will make it more difficult for them to survive. So that's one of the important aspects. So the competitors are still there, but just a domestic competitor has been closed down. But the imports to what we are getting from China, it will make it difficult. So this is one of the aspects. So this is like basically like how it can impact India is what has been said by the industrialist Mr. Birla. The next one, Jio inks the pact with Star India. So we have the Reliance Jio, which has signed a 5-year partnership agreement with Star India to make all the Indian cricket matches available for the users of Jio TV and also the Hotstar in India. So the main objective of this is that they wanted to provide the best sporting content with the best digital infrastructure to the Jio users. So one is this is one of the important aspects, and they also like to continue the superlative customer experience in the areas of sports. So the partnership would cover the T20, ODIs, international test cricket, and there are also the premier domestic competitions of the PCCI. So these are the main partnership to what has been covered in the 5-year partnership agreement between Jio and Star India. So this is about it. Just know about digital infrastructure to what has been developing. You can just quote this to be as one of the point. So this is about it. And the question for the day, you have to brief on the FPIs, that is foreign portfolio investments, and you have to brief on the South China Sea. So these were the important news items for 22/9/2018. Thank you.